Tell me one thing in your life that is great that came as a result of being comfortable.
Life is going to hit you with a certain level of opposition. Life is going to hit you with a certain level of adversity. And life is going to say to you, you said you wanted it. Now let's see how bad you really want it. But the great thing about it, if you love the process, when opposition and adversity hits, you will have a way of embracing it and using it, not only for yourself, but you will use it to make everybody that's connected to you stronger, because your vision has to be larger than yourself. If everything that you do is just about you and for your personal gain, something's gonna come up against you that's gonna be a lot tougher than you. And if it's just about you, the moment you hit it, you're gonna quit and give up every time.
Pain is temporary. It may last for a minute, or an hour, or a day, or even a year, but eventually it will subside, and something else will take its place. If I quit, however, it will last forever.
Because everywhere I look, and everywhere I see in today's society, everybody's doing everything they can to be more comfortable, right? They're looking for the more convenience. They're looking for the quicker. They're looking for the faster. And see, there's opportunity in that for those of you that want to get better. Because I'm going to tell you right now, all the great things in my life, all the great things in other high achievers' lives, all the reasons that these successful people that you look up to, that you aspire to be like, are the way they are, have all come from a place of being uncomfortable. That's just a fact. Okay, so understand that when you're trying to avoid the pain, when you're trying to avoid the struggle, when you're trying to avoid the hard things in life, you are actively choosing to be average. You are actively choosing to be mediocre, and you are actively choosing to move further away from what you want in life, because that hardship and that pain and that struggle and that frustration, they give you the skills that will forge you into a motherfucking champion. All right, so remember that shit when you try to take the easy route. The easy route never pays well. The only route in life that pays well is the hard route. The struggle, the pain, the frustration, and the overcoming of those things. And not only do they pay, they fulfill you as well, because it shows the people around you. It shows your kids. It shows your brothers, your sisters, your friends, your community, what is possible. And there's nobility in that.
Everybody wants the prize, but nobody loves the process. Everybody wants to be a champion, but nobody's willing to put in the work that it takes to be a champion. Everybody wants to hold up the trophy and say, man, I did it, but nobody's willing to put in the work that it takes to do it. I love the process. I love the thought of working for what I want. And I firmly believe you're never supposed to wish for it more than you're willing to work for it. Your expectations never supposed to exceed your effort. But a lot of people, they wish, and they're not willing to work. And the great thing about life has a funny way of testing all of us and seeing how bad we really want what it is that we say we want. Because the thing I know about people can talk the talk. And people do it very well.
You're gonna have to grow up. And some of you have never learned to grow up. And so every time something get hard, you quit, you call mama. I dare you to take a little pain. I dare you. I dare you not to go home. Somebody said, I don't go home, I feel bad. Go through it. You ain't gonna die. At the end of pain is success.
Life is so short. Life only has only a little time. Although it will continue to go on, you cannot hold on and think that every day is promised to you. We have all experienced great losses in our life. We have all felt that pain of losing a loved one, someone that we cared about, but yet we're still here. And now we must go on. But what is the example that we're going to leave? What kind of leadership and what kind of leadership qualities do we have? How do we go on? How do we lead the next generation? Hate is not going to make it work. Being afraid To be truthful to who you are will only limit who you truly are inside. Don't let anyone take that away from you. Don't let anyone take away who you are and how true you are and what you matter in this world to so many other people. Don't be afraid to be honest. Don't be afraid to be truthful. Don't be afraid to be different. Even being different can be difficult to a lot of people. But I guarantee you this, there's nobody in the world that can do you. When the time comes, what would you leave behind? What legacy will be left behind to remind others of your greatness, of your losses, of your victories, of your sorrows? This is a short life that we all have. And it's not easy. It's not easy living it every day. It's not easy to go through so many different circumstances, so many different challenges. It's not easy getting that pink slip, knowing that this may be your last day on your job. It's not easy knowing that you may lose your home because you got laid off your job. This type of pain and these different circumstances, many people are always going to come back and say, well, that's life. We cannot blame life. It is not life that makes these challenges what they are today. It is the purpose. And purpose never lies. It will always tell you the truth. But while you exist in this world right now, I need you to hold on. I need you to hold on strong and don't give up. I need you to believe in every possibility that you have and understand that it is not over for you. I need you to understand life is always going to be good. But always keep in mind, sooner or later, we all got to punch that clock. So carry on and don't give up and don't give in.